Hello everyone, Adam here with Danfoss, and today we're going to be talking about our SVL spare part kits and how they pertain to the REG valve. Here I have the REG 25, which is our 1-inch valve with an A cone. The REG can be used as a hand expansion or regulating valve. With that said, in the inspection kit, you are going to get a number of parts. Some of the parts won't be used for the particular valve as they are pertinent to other older series valves. You will get the replacement O-ring that goes at the base of the cage here. You'll get the replacement nylon gasket that goes underneath of the seal cap. The replacement aluminum gasket that goes underneath of the packing gland in the bonnet. You'll need a pick to remove that. And the replacement fiber gasket that goes between the body and the bonnet. In the repair kit, you will get the same seals that you got in the inspection kit. So we would get the O-ring that goes about the base of this cone here. The replacement nylon gasket that goes underneath of our seal cap. The replacement aluminum crush gasket that goes underneath of our packing gland into the bonnet. Again, you will need a pick to remove this in the existing install. And the fiber gasket that goes between our bonnet and our body. In addition to all of these, you will also get the packing gland. The packing gland can be replaced while the valve is under pressure simply by backseating the valve. For more information on how this works, please see our SVA-S product video. For the overhaul kit for the REG valve, we're going to get all of the same sealing parts that we had previously in the inspection kit. So that would be all of the O-rings, gaskets, and fiber gaskets, the packing gland. And then in addition to this, we're going to get our new replacement cage, a replacement A cone, and a replacement B cone, which has more capacity than the A cone that we're working with today on the size 25 REG valve. In order to replace the cone, the first thing that we need to do is remove the cage. You do this by turning it off of the bonnet and then pulling it down and removing it. Now today we're showing you the parts, but we're going to put the same parts back into service because it's a brand new item. With that removed, you can now locate the set screw on the side of the cone. It requires a 2mm hex head wrench. Using your hex head wrench, get the set screw loose and remove it. Once removed, you now have access to the ball bearings behind the cone. Ensure you have some sort of catch pan or something to locate these on. Then turning the hole downward and keeping it at a constant position while rotating the cone and the spindle, the ball bearings will begin to fall. Once all removed, the cone simply pulls off of the replacement spindle. When replacing the cone, don't forget to retrieve the piece of spring steel located between the spindle and the cone interface. This piece is not in the overhaul kit. So once retrieved, place this back into your new cone. Put the cone back on. And then begin inserting the ball bearings back into the hole from which the set screw was at. In the same manner, we're going to pull this in and then slightly rotate the cone on the spindle to get the ball bearings to take. With all of the ball bearings now fully seated back into the cone and the race, reinsert the set screw, tightening to the recommended torque specification found in our technical data sheet. Once tightened, take the cage assembly with the replaced O-ring, place back onto the spindle and screw all the way on. You want to ensure that there's no gap between the cage and the existing bonnet assembly. Once tight, replace your fiber gasket between the body and the bonnet, place the bonnet back into the body, and retighten your four bolts to the recommended torque specification. This has been an overview for the spare part kits for the SVL product line and how they pertain to our REG-S. For more information about this topic, please see our description below. And for more great videos like this, please visit our YouTube channel, Danfoss Cool US. Thanks for watching.